If you're anything like me, you absolutely hate two things: waiting on things to finish and re-logging in. If you've been messing around with Azure PowerShell, you'll notice that when you launch a script, you authenticate. And for the poor soul that needs to manage resources in multiple Azure subscriptions at the same time, this is kind of a mini nightmare. Well, fear not, my fellow gurus, for I have arrived, hopefully in time, to talk about a way to hold your subscription and authentication information inside Azure PowerShell, called Azure Contexts. Azure Contexts, or Azure PowerShell Context Objects, lets you not only store sign-in information across PowerShell sessions, but to also select the subscription that you want to run Azure PowerShell commandlets on. When you use Contexts, you don't need to re-authenticate your account each time you switch subscriptions. An Azure Context consists of an account used to sign in with Connect AZ account, whether it was a user, an application ID, or a service principal like a managed identity. The next one is a target, which includes the active subscription, the tenant, and the environment the actions will be used on. And finally, the credentials, which is a reference to a token cache, or better put, the stored authentication token for accessing Azure. Where exactly it's stored and for how long is managed by the context autosave settings. Let's dive in and start working with Azure Contexts. All right, we have a PowerShell window open. The Azure module has already been installed, and I have already connected using the Connect AZ account commandlet. When you do that, a context is automatically generated. So let's go ahead and get that context by using the Get AZ context commandlet. Now, since we're going to be working with multiple contexts, I'm going to name this one context 1. The next thing we can do is import a context by using import AZ context and then specifying a path to a JSON file that you create when you save contexts. Now notice that when I imported it, the active context specified by the Get AZ contexts has been changed to the imported one. I can see both of these contexts by using that same commandlet and using the list available parameter. So now I can see that there are two contexts that have currently been loaded in our PowerShell session. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to name the next one context 2. And the next question becomes, how can I switch between these two whenever I'm working through commands? The first way is by using the select AZ context commandlet, where you specify the input object and you can put in the context there. So I can switch back over to context 1. And once again, if I use get AZ context, it'll show me that that one's currently active. Let's go ahead and clear the screen. The second way of using contexts is from each command. So if I were to do something like get AZ resource group, and I just want to select the resource group name. So now we're showing all of the resource groups in context 1. In order to change over to context 2 without making that the default, all I have to do is use the default profile option, which is available in almost every one of the Azure module commands. And I'm going to select context 2. And you can see we have a whole different set of results. In order to save a context, you're going to use the save AZ context commandlet, and then you're going to specify a path. Very similarly that we did with the import AZ context. In order to remove a context, you would use the remove AZ context commandlet. With the input object as the context. So I'll go ahead and remove context 2. And then we'll go ahead and confirm. And we can see only the first context remains. There's two ways to clear credentials. The first one is by disconnect AZ account. And you can use a context in order to define what it's supposed to be, or you could sign out of the current one just by using the disconnect AZ account commandlet. The other way is by using the clear AZ context command. And that will remove all accounts and subscriptions and all sessions. So if I now go to get AZ context, list available, we have nothing, and we're back to the way that we started. Using context in your Azure PowerShell will simplify your life when it comes to managing multiple Azure accounts and subscriptions. You're one step closer to becoming an all-powerful automation machine for any number of environments that you manage. If you want to learn more about Azure PowerShell, check out some of our other ACG Fundamental episodes and the resources listed below. If you enjoyed this video, give it a thumbs up or leave a comment in the forums and consider subscribing to our channel for everything cloud computing. And keep being awesome, cloud gurus.